Welcome back to our proactive London newsroom. I'm talking to Alex Mitchell now. He's a broker over at Options Desk. And Alex, it's great to see you. How are things?
Yeah, really well, Tom. How are you doing? You okay?
Yeah, all good over here. Thank you. We're getting things started on a very busy week. So what is it that you've got your eye on over there?
Yeah, busier week than also what we saw last week. We've got US CPI, which is probably the highlight of the week that we'll see on the US market. Also European Central Bank rate decision, another key event. And then also we've got UK unemployment rate on Tuesday, GDP for the UK on Wednesday, and China industrial production on Friday. So yeah, some big figures there to sort of digest for the week.
Absolutely, yeah. Which of those do you think is going to be the real market mover?
CPI seems to be always seems to be the mover, as you know, with inflation being such a key driver in the States for how well the equity market will do. We saw the jobs number last week in the States was a little bit softer, so kind of leaning towards maybe this soft landing that we hear so much about. But as we saw, you know, Apple were off 6% last week on the back of the Chinese telling their consumers that they can't use the iPhone anymore. So for such a huge weighting for Apple, and obviously we saw Nvidia drop quite a bit as well, then from the July highs, we kind of off sort of 2-3% from, you know, lost 2% last week. So there is still some negative feeling out there. So depending on a good print, you know, on a lower number on the inflation data, we may well see the equity market pick back up in the States. But again, a negative print, we may well see the fall from last week continue into this week.
Could obviously go either way, though there was a bit of a sense of optimism early this morning when we had the FTSE 100 go blasting through that 7,500 point ceiling, Alex. So perhaps that's a sign.
Yes, it was a good sign. We've seemed to have cooled off since then. So yeah, again, with the China industrial figures out on Friday, we've talked about this many a time that, you know, being almost a commodity index, people looking for that China reopening trade to come back into focus. So if we see a good PMI of reading from China, you may well see the miners and the energy companies start to pick up on the FTSE. Recently, Goldman have just come out this morning, actually, to say that they seem to think that we're quite an undervalued market, considering that everyone wants to trade the big, you know, the Magnificent Seven, as we like to call them, all of the big tech stocks in the States. So yeah, be interesting to see Friday. I think some people will be placing some trades in and around the miners on the UK companies. But yeah, CPI is definitely the going to be the mover of the week. And as you say, with the options, we're seeing people sort of place some protection trades around the CPI. But as you say, if it's a good print, there's some call spreads being placed to sort of take advantage of that that big move that we may well see.
It's all heading towards a very juicy Friday roundup, I think, Alex. So hopefully we'll catch you then. But until then, very best of luck out there. And thanks for your time today.
Thanks, Tom. See you soon.